great afternoon for baseball here at Wrigley. We've got the Marlins and Cubs next. No place better for Friday afternoon baseball than Wrigley Field in Chicago. Today, the opener of this three-game set between the East-leading Miami Marlins and the Chicago Cubs. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vasgersian welcoming you into another edition of Baseball on the Show. Alongside me are Eric Karros and Steve Lyons. And Steve, a couple of right-handers set to square off here in the opener.
Well, as you check out the graphic right here, both of these guys pitching exceptionally well this season, both with really low ERAs. And so it's hard to imagine that a lot of runs will be scored in this one.
More from the guys as this one goes along. But first, let's have a look at the starting lineup for the visiting Miami Marlins. As their order here this afternoon will look like this. They'll match up against a guy trying to put it all together, the right-hander Jake Arrieta. And there's a look at the defensive alignment for the Cubs here. Gordon will step to the plate now as we're ready to get this one underway. And the first pitch inside of the afternoon misses for ball one, and that's how things get underway here at Wrigley. EK, one-year-old ball clubs, the Cubs, as they take the field here this afternoon. They come in looking to make it two in a row as they were winners last time out.
And they were able to put together a good performance in the victory yesterday afternoon. So they'll see if they can keep it going here.
Come on, let's do it.
Here's the 1-1. Just does manage to get a piece there as this is bounced foul. Here comes a 1-2. And a good pitch there as this is swung on and missed for the first out of the ball game. Time for a check of the scouting report now as we run you through the arsenal of this 29-year-old right-hander. Christian Yelich will stand in, and he was among the many who failed to record a base hit in the loss yesterday. Now here's the first pitch. Here's a hard hit ball ripped down the first base line. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Here it comes. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit.
You don't want guys to get too comfortable up there, so that's a good idea to run something in tight.
One out, nobody on. Ready now on 1-1. In for a strike, and he jumps ahead 1-2 now.
And that's about where he'll sit with that fastball, 93, 94. And that's plenty hard enough to blow it by guys when you need to.
Now the 1-2. Now a swing as he pulls this one down the line and right. There to pull it in is Soler, and there are two away.
Batting third, right fielder, Giancarlo Stanton.
Giancarlo Stanton will have his first opportunity now as it comes with the bases empty here in the top of the first. First pitch on the way. Fastball in there for a called strike.
It's so important with guys like this to get ahead with strike one. Put them behind in the count and on their back foot right away.
And the pitch. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
And you kind of get the sense that he's not really messing around out there too much. There hasn't been a whole lot of setting guys up here in this inning. He's just trying to get himself back into that dugout as fast as he can.
And now a pitch on the way. And he looks at a ball, 1-2.
On 0-2, if that's a curveball, a changeup, a sinker, then maybe you get a guy to chase. But it's much easier to lay off a pitch down there when it's a straight fastball.
Here comes the 1-2. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. 1-2-3 go the Marlins. And now it'll be the Cubs' turn in a scoreless ball game. A look there at the starting lineup for the Cubs now. They'll have their work cut out for them as they face the Rookie of the Year in 2013 for the National League, Cuban-born right-hander Jose Fernandez. And in the field, the Marlins will align themselves like this. Tommy La Stella will step in now to lead things off in the home half of the first.
Third baseman, Tommy La Stella.
And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
Already hitting 98 miles an hour here in the first inning. He's one of the hardest throwers that these guys will see all year long.
Now the pitch. And a pitch in the dirt as he lays off. It's 1-1.
And we'll see him work both sides of the plate with the curveball going forward. Now, maybe not that far in, but he'll move that pitch around.
Fernandez readying the 1-1. Oh, this is hit hard towards second. But this will be taken in at second base. Good positioning for the first out.
We're starting to see signs that he's about ready to break out of this slump he's been in. He won't get anything to show for it here, but this is a good swing and a hard hit ball. Unfortunately, though, it's just right at somebody.
Dexter Fowler will stand in now, and his batting average currently good for seventh in the National League.
Knock it out, Dexter!
Here's the first offering. Now here's a little tapper down that third baseline, and this could be a tough play. But this is foul for the first strike. Bases are empty, one man out. Now here it comes. There's a fastball pretty close that time, but ruled a ball, 1-1.
He's going to want to keep that pitch down a little more. Day game. Ball will be jumping, so you got to keep that ball in the park today.
And he comes up empty there on a pitch in the dirt and falls behind now 1-2. You get that feeling? That'll be a pitch we see a lot of as this game goes along.
And when he's throwing that thing good, a lot of times that's where it winds up. So these guys are going to have to prove they can lay off that thing in the dirt or they're going to keep seeing it.
Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two.
And obviously, any time you can strike this guy up, you'll take it. I mean, he runs like a greyhound out there. So even routine grounders can sometimes be turned into base hits. Not when you're not making contact, though.
Anthony Rizzo will dig in for the first time here, looking to change his fortunes a bit as he's seen that average dip these last four or so games. Now here's the first pitch. The fastball here is he'll take a look at ball one, 1-0.
The next pitch. And he'll try to check his swing here, but he'll have no such luck. It's strike one. The 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here it comes, 2-1. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this will be a foul ball as that evens things at 2-2. And a fastball swung on and missed, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. We played an inning. No score. Marcell Ozuna will stand in now. He homered in the ballgame yesterday afternoon.
Number 13, Marcell Ozuna.
First pitch to him. And a cut fastball in there for a strike. It's 0-1. The pitch. On the ground to third. Throw to first will be in time, and there's one gone here to start the second.
Batting fifth, first baseman, Michael Morse.
Michael Morse digs in at the plate.
Get you out here.
First offering on the way. And boy, a high strike called there. That's not all that consistent, but it's strike one.
The fastball looks awfully sharp here early on. Sound sharp, too.
Yeah.
Now the pitch.
Woo!
And here's a ball hit in the air. But this will land foul, shy of the wall. Still looking for our first hit in the ball game. Now here's the pitch. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
And now, as a hitter, 1-2, you've got to be thinking right center field. It'll take a little swing out and try to drive something the other way.
The 1-2 with one away. Pitch in the dirt, swung on and missed for strike three, as they'll need to throw to first here. Throw to first will take care of him. Score it 2-3 on the put out, and there are two gone now.
Well, tough to start a game much better than this. He's run through these first five guys pretty easily. This is already his third strikeout of the ball game. Looks like he's in it for the long haul here.
Martin Prado will stand in here, looking to keep the inning alive with two gone now in the top of the second. First pitch coming. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one.
Yeah, those are the ones you like to start in at bat, especially your first time up.
I agree. Give me a nice easy one in the dirt that I can take so I can really get ahead in that count early.
The 1-0 pitch. And he'll lay off here as well, and it's 2-0 to the Miami third sacker. Very patient here in these opening few innings.
And I think that's exactly what they're going to need to do. The more hitters counts that you can get yourself in, the more fastballs you're going to see. And this is a good fastball hitting team.
2-0 on the way. Outside, 3-0 now.
I think at this point, a two-out walk isn't the worst thing in the world. You'd like to avoid it if you can, but this can be a dangerous spot if you just root one.
3-0 is on the way. That one's in there, 3-1.
Not turned loose there. I thought that he might be swinging with two away, but apparently not.
Here he comes, 3-1. And this one misses inside, a ball he walked him, and they've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Yeah, that's nice to see a little patience up there. These guys have been what I would call overly aggressive these first few innings. Finally, somebody's figured out the importance of maybe taking a pitch or two.
So we're runner at first here with two gone in the inning, and that'll bring in Jared Saltalamacchia. First pitch coming. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. Here comes the 1-0. He goes the other way as this is hit well out toward deep left field. And as it turns out, the two-out walk doesn't come around to haunt him as that ends the inning. One left for Miami. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. Jorge Soler will start things off in the bottom of the second.
Right fielder, Jorge Soler.
And here's the first pitch. Now a swing and a fly ball. But this will wind up being a foul ball. Here it comes. And this is fouled back and out of play. Here comes Fernandez, 0-2. Down and away, it's a ball and two strikes.
Yeah, that's the put-away curveball. A great pitch with two strikes. You start it in the zone and then let it work out and see if he'll chase.
The right-hander deals on 1-2. Now a swing and a softly hit ground ball. And a good throw gets him, one gone. Miguel Montero will come forward now, back in the lineup here after getting yesterday afternoon off. Here's the first offering. And a strike called at the letters. Looked high to me, but it's nothing and one.
That's one of those fastballs that just never feels like it's going to be a strike. It's up at the letters, and that's a tough one to do anything with.
Montero waits. Now the pitch. Now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to deep right field. And a diving effort, but he can't make the play in right. And he'll round it and try for third. The relay throw, and it's in time as he's out at third as the good relay gets him.
Well, once his ball got out there, you figured it was a sure double, but he decided to risk it and try for three. It's a pretty big gamble to take when you're already in scoring position, and here, it doesn't pay off.
Here's Starlin Castro. As he'll watch a first pitch curveball drop in there for strike one. 264 is average entering play, 10 home runs, and 29 driven in. Bottom of the second here with no score. Here's the pitch. Off the plate, one ball, one strike.
All right. Now you've just seen two straight breaking pitches miss away. So as a hitter, you're going to eliminate that pitch. No way does he throw it a third time.
Swing and a shot toward right center. And Castro's got himself a base hit.
Well, they just kept going away, away, away. And then finally you just said, I might as well hit it to the opposite field. So that's a great approach right there, and it nets him a base hit.
Here's Javier Baez. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. The average not quite where he wants it, down in the 220s. A dozen home runs and 36 RBIs. A runner on first with two away. The 1-0. 2-0 now.
I'll give him this. He's not intimidated up there. Well, that was inside. Close to triple digits. He didn't even flinch.
Two well count, the pitch.
Yeah.
And here's a fastball for a strike, 2-1 now.
Boy, and this is why you're trying to get yourself into good hitters' counts. This is just right down the middle on 2-0, and swinging at this should be your reward, but he decides to let it go.
2-1. Nip the corner, 2-2. One of the things that makes him so tough to hit, the ability to put his pitches right on the black.
Yeah, I mean, you watch the catcher's glove on some of these, and it literally does not move. That's how good his stuff is.
Sets the 2-2 pitch. Here's a ground ball to first, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Cubs strand one. We'll move to the third with no score. Donovan Solano, ready to go here as we begin the third.
Shortstop, Donovan Solano.
First pitch coming. First pitch of the inning is taken downstairs for a ball. It's 1-0. The 1-0 home. And a good heater as he just watches this baby, a ball and a strike.
Well, that one's at 94, so the velocity's good right now.
1-1 pitch on the way. Grounded, foul. Here's the 1-2. And this is going to be a foul ball. He'll try again, 1-2. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. And the pitch. Now a hard hit ball back up the middle. A dive, but he can't get a glove on it. It's through for a base hit.
Yeah, an ideal setup here with the pitcher on deck. He comes through with a solid single to start things out. Now you give your pitcher a chance to bunt you over and make a productive out.
Jose Fernandez will stand in what would appear to be a sacrifice situation here. Now the first pitch, showing bunt here, but he takes ball one.
And you know, I've always thought, if you're pretty sure a guy might be trying to bunt, then put that first pitch out of the strike zone. Make him show you his intentions. Maybe you get him to offer it something that he shouldn't.
1-0 on the way. And he pulls back the bunt attempt, 2-0. Not the right time to lose the strike zone here.
Definitely not when you've got a guy giving himself up.
Now the 2-0 home. And no take on 2-0. He's still squaring and he gets it down. Boy, and slow out of the box that time as he's tagged out quickly.
Well, this is a nice job here of giving himself up. You see him square and put this ball down over toward the right side of the infield, and that's just where you want it to be. They do put the tag on him, but hey, he gets the job done.
Here's D. Gordon now. Now a fastball here as this is slashed the other way over the third baseman's head. A fair ball. And the run will score as the Marlins have claimed the early 1-0 advantage. And Gordon will make it all the way around to third base. He's got himself a triple.
Well, there's one way to get our first run of the game across. Good hustle there on the RBI triple, and they're in good shape to possibly make it 2-0 with another base hit.
in is Christian Yelich. Now he turns on a fastball here and sends it to deep right field. Catch is made. Here comes the runner from third. And it's a sack fly and an RBI. It's now a 2-0 game.
Just needed to make contact here somehow. Hopefully get the ball in the air. And that's a job well done as it pushes the lead to 2 runs now.
Giancarlo Stanton will try it again. Set down on strikes his first time. Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one. And now's where he can't get discouraged out there. He's still pitching well, only down 2-0. Still plenty of time left to turn it around.
The 1-0. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now. You still come after him now on 2-0?
I think you have to be a little careful, but yeah, I don't think you can just give up on him.
Now the 2-0. And this will be fouled away. Both teams with just 2 hits apiece thus far. Ready with the 2-1. Boy, he just threw that fastball by him.
Just overmatched him there.
Here he comes on 2-2. Now a little dribbler up the line to first. But a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. Two-two pitch on the way. Fouled back. Here comes a 2-2. And a good fastball swung on and missed for strike three, and the inning is over. So they get a couple of runs on 2 hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. The Marlins lead it 2-0. Chris DiNorfio will stand in looking for a bleeder, a bloop single, anything to kickstart the average a bit because he's had a rough go of it these past 6 ball games. Now here's the first pitch. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. And here's a ball hit in the air. But this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-1. And he'll come back with one in the dirt as the count moves to 2-1 now. A 2-1 offering. On the ground down the first base line, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. The 2-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
You know, now that we've made it to just about the midway point of the season, this is where you start to see a little bit of separation between the haves and the have-nots. And I think we can pretty safely say that these guys are in it for the long haul.
Jake Arrieta will get his first shot at it here. Now the first pitch. Too low, 1-0.
1-0.
Now the 1-0 runs outside, so it goes to 2-0 now.
Well, you know, sometimes it's that natural tendency to let up just a little bit when you're facing the opposing pitcher. You know he's not going to do much damage, but you got to get refocused here because you do not want to go 3-0 to him.
In the dirt, it's 3-0 now. Bad time for the command to do a disappearing act.
He will kick himself if he loses this guy.
Now the 3-0 offering. And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
Don't be surprised if he still doesn't have the green light on 3-1.
Here he comes on 3-1. And the good fastball there finds the zone as the count goes full now. 3-2. A pretty dangerous spot for that one.
I don't think it was by design. It's one thing to miss your spots out of the zone, but when you miss in the zone, especially up, that's when you tend to get hurt.
And that swung on and fouled straight back. The next 3-2. Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. And he finally wins the battle as this is swung on and missed for the second out. So back-to-back strikeouts for him here to start the inning. And as you can see there on the team leaderboard, he's currently tops on the ball club in that department as we approach the All-Star break. Tommy La Stella will stand in here hoping to at least put a ball in play here this inning. Here's the first offering. A fastball off the plate away. It's ball one. One oh pitch now. That misses. 2-0. Two out, nobody on. Here comes the 2-0.
Here we go.
Swing and a ball hit softly on the ground. But this will get foul, 2-1. Now the 2-1 pitch. Big swing, but a little dribbler here to the right side of the mound. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Cubs are down in order. They're still down. It's 2-0. Marcelo Zuna will stand in now to get us going here in the fourth.
Fielder number 13, Marcel Ozuna.
First pitch on the way. Now a ball lined towards center field, and that's a base hit.
As we look at that again, you know, this is not a bad pitch by any stretch. If he throws this pitch 10 times, I bet he gets him out 9 of them. But here you just have to tip your cap to the guy at the plate.
Here's Michael Morse now, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. Is that really the spot you want to be messing with here?
It shouldn't be. That's a danger zone, if you ask me.
He's ready now. The pitch. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Ah, that thing's knee-high on the outside third of the plate. Pretty understandable why he couldn't catch up with that one.
He waits. Now the pitch. And he missed with it. It's 1-2.
Well, I think that fastball is just for show there. He's not trying to throw this for a strike.
Go!
2 runs, 3 hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. 1-2. Now a swing and a hard hit ball to short. One there. On to first, and the return throw takes care of Morse, a double play.
Well, that's just made to order right there. Two hops to short, easy pivot, not a lot of heat at second base. That's just a pretty routine double play.
Martin Prado will stand in. He drew base on balls his first time. Now here's the first pitch. fastball too high to start him out here 1-0. Here's the 1-0. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's the 1-1. He got the high fastball there, and he popped it straight up. LaStella is there to make the catch, and the side is retired. Dexter Fowler will be the one to lead it off when we come back. It's the Marlins 2 and the Cubs nothing. And there is Dexter Fowler. As we told you, he'll start things out here in the home fourth.
Dexter Fowler.
First pitch to him. Curveball looked at here for strike one.
And against a guy like this, you're usually only going to get one pitch to hit in that bat. Sometimes you might not even get that, so that's one he may want back.
And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Grounded foul toward the third base dugout. The 1-2. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. The 2-2 coming. And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out.
Wow, a real sharp break to this thing. It's a slider, and he starts it out over the middle of the plate. The hitter thinks he's got something that he can handle, and then this thing just makes a beeline right for his hands. That is a tough pitch.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now. He'll pick on the first pitch and hit a ground ball towards second. On to first, and there are two down.
Now back, right fielder, Jorge Soler.
Jorge Soler will stand in. He grounded out his first time. First pitch coming. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one.
Water. Get your water here.
1-0 on the way. And this one's too far inside, ball two.
Two really close pitches to kick off this at bat. Normally this guy would be all over him, but he's shown some discipline here with two good takes.
Two out, nobody on. Here comes the 2-0. Swing and a miss on the heater, and it's 2-1.
Yeah, kind of a late decision to swing there. Even if he hits that thing, that might just be a routine fly to right.
Here comes the 2-1. This is hit out to right. Does he have another 1-2-3 inning? He does. Seven in a row he's set down now as the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They trail things here 2-0. Jared Saltalamacchia will make his way towards the box to lead off the fifth.
Number 39, Jared Saltalamacchia.
First offering on the way. Swing and he pops him up over toward foul territory. And no one can get there. He'll try it again. Pitch on the way. That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2. High strikes, probably not on the docket for places he wants to be.
Yeah, I mean, it's no secret. got to keep the ball down against a team like this. If you go up every once in a while with a fastball, you'll be fine, but you're not going to last too long if you make a habit of working up there with your secondary pitches.
Here comes a 1-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. Here he comes again, 1-2. And this is hit well towards the hole. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
And now you just start to wonder, how much is the heat taken out of this guy? You see the pitch count. It's not all that bad just yet, but he's been in and out of trouble a few times already, so he's definitely had some max effort innings.
Donovan Solano will stride in again. He singled and later scored his first time. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. And here's the first pitch. Took a little off, and it's in for a called strike one. Two runs, four hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. He's ready. Now the pitch. Now a fastball here, not close, and it's one and one now. Here comes the 1-1. And there he goes towards second. Fouled back. A runner at first with no outs here. Now the 1-2. And here's a slider. Strike three called, and that'll be the first out of the inning.
Well, let's get you a shot of his reaction at the plate in show motion. You think he agreed with the call? I don't think he did.
Stepping in now, Jose Fernandez, wanting to avoid the double play here as he gets this one down. Flip to the second baseman covering now for the out.
You know, in this situation, some people may say, with one out, why not just let him swing away? You know why you don't let him swing away? Because he's a pitcher, that's why. All you can hope for is for him to go up there and make a productive out, and that's what he did.
D. Gordon will dig in now, 1-for-2 to this point. Here's the first offering. Low for ball one. Here's the 1-0. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Yeah, he's got an open base here. Looks like he's going to use it.
The 2-0 on the way. Not fooled there as this ball's hammered out to deep right field. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Marlins leave one. They're up 2-0. Miguel Montero will stand in to start things out here in the home half of the fifth. And you get the sense, Steve, that this crowd's been pretty well taken out of the ballgame to this point.
Yeah, they pretty much had to sit on their hands all afternoon. Not a lot to get excited about so far. And I think that's a credit to that man out there on the mound. He's cut right through this lineup for the first four innings.
First pitch coming. And that swung on and fouled straight back. Montero waits. Now the pitch. That misses wide. One ball and one strike.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just watch it all the way in.
Now the 1-1. out in front as he pulls this one down the line at first. But a foul ball. 1-2 the count now. Here comes the 1-2. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2. Four pitches. Fast, slow, fast, slow. EK, you thinking fastball here?
It seems to fit the pattern, but you better not get too predictable out there. Guys will catch on quick.
Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out. So after getting the strikeout on the fastball, not a bad time to check out our pitch speed comparison for our two starters. And whoa, look at that for a top speed. 98 miles an hour. That man is flat dealing. Starlin Castro will dig in. He singled his first time around. First pitch coming. Well hit high in the air and deep to center field. And he will run this one down. A good read off the bat for the second out.
The first thing a pitcher does when he walks out of the tunnel here at Wrigley, he'll take a look at those flags and see which way they are blowing. I mean, this place, it can play like two totally separate ballparks from one day to the next.
Javier Baez will stand in now with two away, trying to avoid another 1-2-3 inning.
Now, this has been total domination these past few innings. They haven't been able to mount any kind of threat whatsoever.
Now, the first pitch. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes.
Well on his way to another good inning right here, and you see the pitch count. It's not even close to being a factor just yet.
Now the 1-0 pitch. Here's a changeup that's right there, 1-1.
And you would think that this heat would start affecting him sooner or later, but it hasn't so far.
If anything, he's getting stronger as the day goes on.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Here's the 1-1 pitch. Swing and a ball chop foul down the left side. The right-hander deals on 1-2. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Here now the 2-2. And this misses, so that'll fill the count at 3-2.
I think he had him flinching on that one. That nearly came back to the inside corner.
Full count pitch on its way. And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Just the first walk he's given up here so far to go along with just the two hits. So he's been pretty well in command throughout this entire start.
Chris D'Onofrio will dig in now, hoping to perhaps make him pay for the two-out walk. Here's the first pitch to him. And he starts the number eight hitter with a strike, nothing in one.
Well, you get the sense that what they need is one big hit from anybody in the lineup. If they could get one, it could get them right back in this game, because right now they just seem out of it.
He's set, now the pitch. That's over, but low, it's a ball and a strike. Seemed to quicken his delivery to the plate on that last pitch.
Well, you got to remember, the slide step does two things for you. It gets the catcher the ball quicker so he can throw a guy out, or it will hold the runner on first so he doesn't steal at all.
Fernandez readying the 1-1. And here's a pitch swung on and missed, 1-2 now.
Yeah, one pitch away now from getting through five shutout innings. And I'll tell you what, the way he's throwing, this could turn out to be a night off for the bullpen.
Two out with the man at first. Here's the 1-2. Ball two. Here's the 2-2 offering. Fastball misses in the dirt as he tried to get him to chase the low one.
And now, 3-2, two out. He'll be helped by the fact that that runner will get a head start out there.
The 3-2 pitch. And he swings and pops it foul behind the plate. And he'll lunge out of the crouch to put this one away. Good reactions there, and the inning is over. One left for the Cubs. They trail it here 2-0. Christian Yelich will stand in to lead things off as the Marlins look to get things started here in their half of the sixth. Now here's the pitch. Big slow breaking ball that drops in for a strike to start him out. It's nothing and one. Now here it comes. And he puts a pretty good jolt into this one, high and deep to center. And the sixth inning opens with a flyout, one away.
Well, he is definitely doing his part out there. You see his line so far. He's keeping his guys in the ball game. He's just not getting any help offensively.
Giancarlo Stanton will get another shot, struck out swinging his last time. Now the first pitch. And they start him with one high and away for ball one.
And even though he's pitching well, this is a part of the order that he's really got to worry about. Now they can turn a good outing into a bad one pretty darn quickly.
Here's a 1-0. Off the plate again. 2-0 now.
A much better approach here at the plate so far. Now he's not working from behind in the count like he has his first few at-bats.
One out, nobody on. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Outside and low, 3-0. Pretty clear the plan is to keep everything away.
And that's smart for most guys, but you've got to know your scouting report because this is a guy that can cover the outside part of the plate.
Here comes the 3-0. And he gets this fastball over, back to 3-1 now.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
Now the 3-1 pitch. Oh, Stanton with a big swing at that one, but he got there a little too quickly, and this is going to hook foul. Here's the full count offering. And he struck him out. And there's the hat trick, as that's his third strikeout of the ball game.
Well, there it is. Hat trick, my friend. That's a third strikeout of the game. Luckily, his guys are winning, so it kind of lessens the blow, but actually, not so much.
Here's Marcelo Zuna, as he'll take strike one on the inside corner. Now the pitch. Over towards the dugout, but this one will get into the stands. Now the pitch. Out of play. The next 0-2. Tried to get him to go after the slider, but it's 1-2. Two out, nobody on. Here's the pitch. And he struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Miami down in order, but they're on top 2-0. Jonathan Herrera is going to come off the bench as he'll be asked to lead off the bottom of inning number six. Marlins has some action in the bullpen now as a right-hander is up and throwing. And here's a fastball called for strike one. He continues to get ahead here. He's been in complete control.
I think you need to guard yourself from being overconfident, though. A bloop and a blast could still turn this game on its ear.
Late decision to swing that time, and as a result, it's 0-2.
And we've seen guys swing at that four-seam riding fastball up in the zone, but you're never going to get on top of that thing when it's up that high.
Here comes Fernandez, 0-2. Shooting for that low inside corner, but he missed with it, 1-2.
Tough pitch to lay off there with two strikes. I'm not sure if that was a good take or whether he just got fooled on a changeup and couldn't pull the trigger.
1-2. Inside for a ball, so he misses with two straight here, and it's back to 2-2.
You know, I think you have to ask yourself, was he trying to throw a fastball for a strike right there? Or was he just trying to set me up for that changeup away?
Got him.
Well, this is one of those situations where his guys got him the lead early on, and he's been in complete control ever since. I mean, he's barely been threatened out there.
Tommy La Stella will stand in, and he, like so many others, hitless in the ballgame so far. Here's the first offering. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. The pitch. Back-to-back fastballs here as he takes control, 0-2.
Come on, drifting anything close.
Here comes Fernandez, 0-2.
Here we go.
And look out as that one ran in and got him.
You just don't see that, like, ever. Not in that situation, not in that count. That's a big break from an offensive standpoint. Now you've got to find a way to make that hurt somehow.
Dexter Fowler will dig in. Strikeout victim his last time.
What was that?
First pitch on the way. First pitch here misses wide, 1-0.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now. That's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving it up there like that.
The 1-0 pitch. There goes the runner. Pitches a cold strike. The throw. Might have been in time, but it's high, and it allows his man to dive in safely.
And this is one dude that's tough to phase out there. After getting hit by the pitch, he says, "All right, man, you're going to pay for that." He's into scoring position now on the stolen base.
Get on base, Dexter!
The 1-1 home. Now a little bouncer into no man's land down that third baseline. But a foul ball, 1-2 now. The 1-2 with one away. Lays off, 2-2 now. Here's the 2-2 home. And he gets a piece here as this ball is fouled away. Now the 2-2 pitch. Full count, 3-2. Anthony Rizzo, who represents the possible go-ahead run here, waits in the on-deck circle. Here's the 3-2 pitch. Opposite field to left. This will hang up just long enough to be run down in shallow left for a tough second out.
First baseman
Well, I thought the shutout was going to be over once I saw this ball hit, but the ball does wind up being pretty much right at him, and he's able to get a glove on it and keep him out of the run column.
Anthony Rizzo will step in now, representing the potential tying run.
Keep in mind, he is the team leader in home runs, so if anyone's got a shot of getting one out of here, it's him.
Now here's the first pitch. There's a fastball missing down and away for a ball, 1-0. Runner in scoring position at second with two down. Here comes the 1-0. Up around the letters with that one for ball two. Looks like he's not going to see anything here.
Yeah, I don't think so either. They gave him two shots to see if he'd go out of the zone to try to chase. And after that, I'm thinking they should just put him on.
The 2-0. Swing and a ball hit hard on the ground is short. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. A golden opportunity to get on the board. Here goes for naught. On to the back third here this afternoon, and we've got it for you on the show. Welcome back here to the historic friendly confines of Wrigley Field. It's on to the seventh inning with the Marlins on top, and it's a good time to check out our game summary through the first six innings of play. Neil Ramirez is on to pitch now as he'll take over to start inning number seven.
Neil Ramirez.
Michael Morse will stand in looking to turn things around. He's struck out and bounced into a double play so far. Not such a hot start. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. Called a strike on the outer half, 0-1. Pitch on the way. Off the plate, one ball, one strike. Now, how important is it going to be for this guy to throw that curveball for strikes?
I don't know that he necessarily needs to ever throw it for a strike. I mean, if it's around the plate and he's getting guys to go after it, it's doing its job, but if he starts to get too high or too far outside, then it's just an easy take.
And he'll take a look at a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-2.
But this is the thing that's so impressive about this guy. He'll show you that good breaking ball, but then he'll run that fastball up the ladder at 92, 93.
Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Well, let's take a look at the sequence here on Show Track. The first three pitches, they're all going to be down in the zone. So now you've got the guy thinking he's going to see something else around the knees. Boom. That's when they change the sight level and get that last pitch by him at the letters.
Martin Prado now, as the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. The next pitch.
Yep.
A high strike there, and it's 1-1.
Yeah, there's a good one right there, right over the top. Just fire that thing in there.
Strike him out.
Now here's the pitch. Down low, two balls and a strike. Here's the 2-1 pitch. Oh, it wanted that one, but it misses for ball three.
He knows the drill out there. You've got to make him swing the bat and not be giving up walks at this stage of the game, because those could be fatal.
Bases are empty, one man out. The 3-1 is on the way. And a fastball misses there, ball four.
And you'd like to say, good job there, good eye. But in reality, nobody's swinging at that pitch. It's not even close.
Jared Saltalamacchia will come forward now. He has flied out and singled so far.
Come on, guys, turn two!
First pitch to him. And this is low, ball one.
One ball, no strike. Come on, turn the double.
Runners on first with one down. The 1-0 home. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. One-one on the way. Now a swing and a bouncing ball toward the hole. Here's Castro for one. Back to the pitcher covering. It's a double play and the inning is over. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. Get out the microphone. Stretch time here at Wrigley. It's the Marlins 2 and the Cubs nothing. Jorge Soler will step in now. He's bounced out and flown out in his first two plate appearances. And now the Marlins bullpen will swing into action as a lefty and a right-hander start to get loose. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0.
Well, this is a spot where it helps to have a two-seam fastball like that so you can work in on the right-handed hitters.
1-0 on the way. Swing and a miss as he ramps up on the fastball, 1-1.
And here's where you don't need to be an RBI guy. You don't need to be a home run guy. You have to be a leadoff guy. Just get on base somehow to give that tying run on deck a shot.
1-2 now.
And if he's getting tired, it's not showing in his slider. That pitch is still as tight as it was in the second inning.
The 1-2. Fouled straight back. Now another 1-2. Misses, ball two.
Yeah, it's a good battle to start this inning. That's what you like to see when you've got a guy out there that's getting up there in the pitch count.
Two, two. This ball's grounded foul. Sets the 2-2 pitch. Ball swung on and lifted in the air with some carry out towards left center. There to handle it is Ozuna, and there's one away. Miguel Montero will stand in. He's 1-for-2 so far. Now here's the first pitch. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Yet again, another first pitch strike.
And it's a big reason of why he's having the success he is. You establish the count in your favor right away and it just opens up the door to so many more options going forward.
Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
Well, one thing we've seen from this guy on the mound so far, when he makes bad pitches, they typically miss out of the strike zone. They don't miss in the zone where they can be crushed.
Now the 1-1 pitch. On a hole now as he swings and misses at a pitch in the dirt, and it's 1-2 now. And through 6 1/3, he's about to hit the 100 pitch mark now. One out, nobody on. Now the 1-2 home to Montero. Hit hard but fouled off to the left, and that'll keep you honest as a third base coach. Montero waits, now the pitch. And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
And for all the pitches he's thrown, only one walk so far. That's a little bit surprising.
Come on, Cubs!
Here he comes on 2-2. And he struck him out, and that's 8 strikeouts thus far.
And for a catcher playing in this heat, taking all those foul tips, squatting, you know he's dead tired after being out there all day. So maybe you can forgive him just a little bit if his bat speed isn't lightning quick right now.
Starlin Castro will dig in now. A single and a flyout for him in 2 trips thus far. Now here it comes. I had him guessing that time as he's barely able to foul it away. Here it comes. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And that will conclude matters here in the 7th. Cubs are down in order. They're down 2-0. Donovan Solano will stand in now. He singled and struck out in 2 trips. Donovan Solano. First pitch coming. There's a strike at the knees, 0-1. And the pitch. One strike pitch is a fastball high, and that evens things at 1. Ready now on 1-1. 1-2.
Yeah, from 94, he dials this one back to 79, and he gets him to swing and miss.
Here comes a 1-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Well, it's been a game of starting pitching so far, as on cue we give you a look at our starter comparison for these two guys in our 2-0 ball game. Ichiro Suzuki will get the call here as he'll hit for the pitcher.
Number 51, Ichiro Suzuki.
And here's a called strike now to the 41-year-old vet. It's nothing and 1.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now throw anything off of.
Now the pitch. And this is high, a ball and a strike. Here's the 1-1. There's a swing and a ball lifted to left, but back in the seats, out of play. It's 1-2. Now the 1-2 to 2 balls and 2 strikes now. Bases are empty, 1 man out. 2-2 pitch on the way. And a good pitch there as this ball sent out to straightaway central for Fowler. And he's got it for out number 2. Very brisk pace to the ball game thus far. 2-0 our score as you get a look there at the line score to this point in the contest. D. Gordon will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Now pitch on the way. Curveball just misses apparently. 1-0. The 1-0. And this is going to find the crowd down the left field line. It's a ball and a strike. Pitch on the way. Hit high but foul, as that'll get in amongst the fans. Now the 1-2 home to Gordon. And a good take there. Close, but it's 2-2.
Oh, the crowd thought they had him, but definitely outside. Not by a whole lot, though.
Bases are empty here with two men out. The 2-2. And a bouncing ball, foul. Here comes a 2-2. Swing and a liner. Foul. Ready with another 2-2. And he's getting his money's worth up there now. It's full 3-2.
And this guy won't lay down here because there's two outs and nobody on. He's putting up a good fight.
Now the 3-2 pitch. Now a swing and another fly ball here as things are getting busy out there in Central. And this is into the alley and ought to be good for extra bases. Around second now, heading for third. And he'll make it into third here with a two-out triple.
Yeah, getting one triple in a game is rare enough, but getting two is something you might see once a year. But just like the last one, he hits second base here under a full head of steam and makes it into third with his second triple of the ball game.
In is Christian Yelich. As the first pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball one. The 1-0. A ball hit hard to the left side. And no shot to knock this one down. And that's going to score the run from third. And that'll bring home run number three. It's now a 3-0 cushion.
Two away, that's a big at-bat right there. You don't want to leave that guy stranded over at third, so that's a nice job of finding a ball he can square up, then driving it for an RBI single.
Brian Schlitter will take over here with a runner at first and two gone in the inning. Giancarlo Stanton will stand in, and they've been able to hold him in check so far, 0-for-3 to this point.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising that he's been a non-factor in this one, usually a major force in their offense.
Let's go, Cubby!
First offering on the way. And he couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane to the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Pause, now the pitch. Oh, and he's definitely getting the best of this matchup as he fires another fastball past him for strike two. He's set, now the pitch. And he gets him to lift one into shallow center field. And Castro will make the catch, and that ends the inning. So they pick up a run on two hits, no errors, and a man left. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Marlins 3 and the Cubs nothing. A.J. Ramos is on out of the bullpen now as he'll take over to start the bottom of the eighth.
A.J. Ramos.
Javier Baez will stand in. Base on balls his last time.
Second baseman, Javier Baez.
And a bit too high with that one. It's 1-0. Now the 1-0. Ball two.
You got to think one thing here. Get on base. A walk will do the trick.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. Hitters count 2-0. In there, 2-1. Now the 2-1. Called strike that time, and it's even at 2-2. Here now the 2-2. Not where he wanted that fastball to be, and it's 3-2 now. One thing that man right there will not tolerate, leadoff walks.
Especially right out of the bullpen. This might be a quick outing if that happens.
3-2, here it is. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning.
And if he could have been just a little more patient there, would have had a leadoff walk. Instead, chases it out of the zone here and winds up costing.
In now, Chris D'Onofrio, as he'll take a look at a strike right down the middle. It's 0-1.
And time's getting short here. You don't want to have to face that closer in the ninth inning needing three runs. They need to cut that gap down somehow.
Now action in the bullpen as their closer starts to get loose out there. The pitch. Low of the fastball here in the dirt even. Hits ball one. One one pitch on the way. And he finds a way to catch the zone here. It's 1-2.
Yeah, it's hard to look for a change up there, especially when a guy's got a good live fastball.
The right-hander deals on 1-2. Now a swing, and he just fouls this one away. Another 1-2 delivery. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now. Here's the 2-2 offering. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
I'd say he's made a pretty good impression since coming on. Two batters, two strikeouts to start the inning.
Chris Coughlin will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 8, Chris Coughlin.
Now a fastball that couldn't quite find the zone. It's ball one. Fouled toward the third base dugout, but this will get back into the seats out of play. The 1-1. 1-1 pitch, a curveball that's right there. One ball, two strikes.
Boy, it's been a good solid inning so far out of the pen. Let's see if he can wrap this one up.
Here comes the 1-2. Just got a piece of it as it's fouled back. Now here it comes. And a breaking ball down and in here as he's got to hop out of the way there.
Yeah, and on 1-2, when you know the guy at the plate needs to protect, that's a great spot for that curveball. A lot of guys, they would have gone fishing for that.
Two out, nobody on. The 2-2 coming. Swinging a ball hit on the ground, but this is going to be a foul ball as that keeps things at 2-2. Here's the 2-2 home. And a full count as that misses. It's 3-2 now.
Wow, what an at-bat he's having right now. He's fought off some tough pitches. He's laid off a few pitches like that one. And now he's worked his way back to a 3-2 count.
3-2, here it comes. And he's just going to make him throw as many pitches as he can as he fouls another one away, and it's still full at 3-2. Once again, a 3-2. And he lays off ball four, so he comes right off the bench and works the walk. Usually easier said than done.
Yeah, they went to the slider there on 3-2, and that's a pitch where you're really hoping the hitter will see fastball swing through it. But it didn't work out that time. He winds up losing him.
Tommy La Stella will stand in now in what could be a real make-or-break situation.
You think at this point you have to get something out of this inning. The further you get into that bullpen, the tougher it's going to be to claw back from this deficit.
Here's the first offering. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Here's the 1-0. And a slider's in the dirt as he lays off it for a ball.
Yeah, and he didn't even have to think twice about that one. And now he's got a good hitter's count here, 2-0.
Now the 2-0. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. Here he comes on 2-1. Swing and a grounder fouled, and that almost took the first base coach along with it. A runner on first with two away. 2-2. And this is going to be a foul ball. Now the 2-2 pitch. Swing and a ground ball towards the hole. And eight innings have come and gone now as the inning is over. Cubs strand one. They trail it here 3-0. Blake Parker come on now to start the ninth inning as he looks to keep this deficit right where it is for the bottom of the ninth. Marcell Ozuna will try again. Struck out swinging his last time through. Grounded foul off to the right. Here's the pitch. And here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1.
Oh, come on.
Here's the 1-1. And this is taken for a called strike. And he's not in love with that call either. It's 1-2 now.
Yeah, he must have been looking for that same breaking ball because that pitch, it's right there.
Here's the 1-2. And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Here he comes on 2-2. And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. And it'll fade just at the end and winds up a long foul ball. Now another 2-2. And this is fouled back and out of play. Here's another 2-2. And a swing and a miss. Good pitch there for the first out here in the ninth.
And sometimes it doesn't quite matter how hard a thrower a guy is. If he can locate, he's going to be successful. The location here is absolutely spot on. Right on the inside corner. That's a tough, tough pitch.
Here's Michael Morse now. As he'll wait out a breaking pitch here that finds the zone for strike one.
And you can see him trying to be a little bit more patient here. He's got two strikeouts already, but he's got to be careful not to fall too far behind.
One out, nobody on. Now here's the pitch. Fastball swung on and grounded out towards second. Throw gets him, two down.
Well, that's just good pitching right there. Really ties him up with that fastball in on the hands. And he hits just a simple ground ball there for the easy out.
Martin Prado will stand in. Base on balls his last time. And here's the first pitch. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. And the pitch. Now the 0-1 is swung on and hit on the ground to third. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Nothing across here this half. Nothing further in the Miami ninth. Last chance coming up now for the Cubbies. They trail here 3-0. Steve Cishek is on now to try to close things down here in the ninth.
Number 31, Steve Cishek.
Dexter Fowler to stand in to lead things off, as the top of this batting order really hasn't been much of a factor so far.
Yeah, between the top three guys in this lineup, no hits between them. And you got to figure you're not going to win too many games when that's the case.
Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Pitch now. Ball two now.
It looks like he's going to be taken until he gets a strike. Not a bad plan when you're down by three in the ninth.
The 2-0. Not even the fastball can find the zone here, and he's run it to 3-0.
And it goes without saying, but this has to be in the strike zone. You don't want him on base to start off the inning.
Here it comes, the 3-0. And he finally gets a sinker over here for a called strike one. You have to figure that sinker is going to be an important pitch for him here this afternoon.
No question about it. Obviously, it's his ground ball pitch, so if you're a hitter, you're going to need to make him bring that pitch up a bit.
Now the 3-1. Here's a swing and a chance now for the first baseman, Morse. And he'll take this to the bag himself. One gone here in the ninth. So the leadoff man gone to start the top of the ninth as we take a look at league saves leaders entering play. And as you see there, he's sitting in second place in the National League in that department. Anthony Rizzo will stand in, needing to do something here to get on base as they're down to their final two outs. First pitch coming. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Now the pitch. Ani looked like a caveman swinging a club on that one. It's 0-2 now.
That got in his kitchen big time right there.
Now here's the pitch. And now here's the ball hit pretty well out toward right center field. Ozuna is there, and quickly two are gone here, and it's not looking good for the home nine.
Yeah, and now just one out away from wrapping up this one, and that would certainly be a good way to start the series if they can take game one on the road.
Jorge Soler is the last chance now with two out here in the ninth. Now the first pitch. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. You have to say they've really had a good game plan for attacking the 3-4-5 hitters all game long.
Yeah, and I think the only thing that's better than a game plan has been the execution of that game plan. You're exactly right. They've held this lineup at bay.
Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. Bases are empty here with two men out. The 1-1. And here's a sinker that had a little bit too much dart to it there as it just about came in and nailed him.
Yeah, he's not trying to hit him, I don't think, but sometimes you need to keep guys honest up there. I think that's all he was trying to do there.
Ready on 2-1. And this is swung on and missed, so the Cubs are down to their final strike here.
Oh, and he's sure got a good one, doesn't he? That ball goes from about knee-high to ankle-high in the matter of about 5 feet.
Two out, nobody on.
You can do it!
2-2 pitch on the way. Swing and a miss. He struck him out, and that'll do it here as the ball game is over.
Yeah, you know, this game kind of felt like it could have been played back in 1968. Very well played, very low scoring, very quick game, too. I'll tell you, I could go for a few more of these this year. That'd be okay by me.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Well, you always hope to get a good outing from your starting pitcher, but this man went above and beyond in this one. He's our top player of the game.
Yeah, I thought he turned in a really good performance. His fastball had some good life to it, really mixed his speed well, and he kept guys guessing all throughout.
So that's a wrap here this afternoon. For EK, Psycho, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt Vaskersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, log on to theshownation.com. The Marlins win it 3-0. So long from Wrigleyville.